Welcome back. If you've just joined us, you're watching the news at 10 on Channels Television, coming to you live from Lagos.
Airtel, the smartphone network.
We can now share with you some of those pictures that were sent to us. And the first one is this photo from Bonny Island in River State, showing the collapsed portion of a classroom. Our eyewitness reporter is asking state authorities to fix it. The next one was sent in from Yenagoa, the Bayelsa state capital, and it shows a flooded compound. Here's one from Asaba Federal Highway in Delta State. It shows a broken down vehicle on this bad road. The next photo is from Ulodi Apapa here in Lagos State, showing a flooded road as well. Our eyewitness reporter is calling on the federal government to construct larger drains. Finally is this picture of a bad road from Alhaji Ayorinde Street in Mafuluku area of Oshodi. Our eyewitness reporter wants the government to repair it.
Airtel, the smartphone network.
Thanks a lot for sending your pictures and send us some more. Entrenching integrity and accountability is the new focus for the Nigeria Police Force as Mr. Idris Ibrahim officially takes over as Acting Inspector General of Police. The police chief, who becomes the 19th Indigenous Inspector General, has promised a safer and peaceful nation, increased deployment of technology, as well as improved officers' welfare. Our correspondent Gloria Umezuoke reports.
On arrival of the former Inspector General of Police and the incumbent, the Niger State Governor, among a host of other top-ranking officers of the Nigerian police, the handover ceremony commenced. Mr. Solomon Erase, appointed by the last administration, bows out after 14 months in office with a promise.
No nation is immune from criminal activities. Today, however, like any other police force across the world, we in the Nigerian Police Force can beat our chest and make a clear and bold statement to criminal elements threatening our national value that if you commit any crime, we now have the capacity not only to arrest you, but to bring you to deserve justice in the most prompt, professional, and rule of law compliant manner.
At this time, it is expected that a transfer of authority is passed on. The new Inspector General of Police comes on board with a lot of zeal to professionalize the police and a number of reforms.
Concerted effort will be made to establish at least one police logistic forensic laboratory in each of the geopolitical zones of the country. This will boost the capacity of the police to effectively and efficiently investigate and prosecute crimes within the organization. Coordination with other security agencies is very critical at this period of our security challenges in the country. Therefore, there should be established in every police headquarters a joint operation center for effective coordination and synergy with other security agencies to adequately respond to major crises 24/7.
The acting inspector general, who hails from Kutigi, Niger State, was enlisted into the Nigerian police force in 1984 and holds a degree in law from the University of Maiduguri. Mr. Ibrahim, who was in charge of operations at the force headquarters before his appointment, replaces Solomon Erase, who retires today. Gloria Umezuke, Channels Television News.
The governor of Ekiti State, Mr. Ayodele Fayose, has been explaining where he got the monies he spent on his campaign in the 2014 Ekiti governorship election, where he emerged winner. Mr. Fayose today in Ado Ekiti told journalists that a second-generation bank was responsible for the funding of his campaign, and he also got donations from other sources. The governor denied receiving any monies from the office of the former National Security Advisor or directly from the former NSA, Colonel Sambo Dasuki.
I wish to state clearly that my election was funded 2 years ago by Zenith Bank PLC. Fundraising, donations from friends and associates, as well as sale of campaign souvenirs. I have no financial transaction whatsoever with the Office of the National Security Advisor under Colonel Sambo Dasuki, retired. and former Minister of State for Defense, Senator Musli Obanyokuru, either by cash, check, or electronic transfer. I challenge the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission to public statements made by Senator Musli Obanyokuru, his son, or any other person associated with money from the NSA's office, where they claimed that they gave me money for the election, because as it is only acting a movie scripted, produced and directed by all progressives, Congress, government of President Muhammadu Buhari, just to silence me being a major opposition voice.
Governor of Ekiti State, Mr. Ayodele Fayose. In the meantime, Zenith Bank says it does not want to join issues with the Ekiti State governor, but explains that the bank does not fund campaigns for politicians as a corporate policy. Instead, it says that Zenith Bank has dealings with all political parties, be they APC or PDP, only in the area of funding, but as account holders. The management also says that it has records of dealings with its former staff, who are now politicians, but certainly not that of Governor Ayo Fayose. It, however, acknowledges that the governor operates accounts with it. Let's cross over to Abuja now, shall we? Here's Yemisi Ikpai. Yemisi.
Hello, Ijoma. Great to have you join us, and welcome to Abuja, the nation's capital. In a bid to ascertain the actual amount that's been realized so far through the Treasury single account policy, the House of Representatives is to set up an ad hoc committee to look into the matter. Sponsored by Representative Adamu Kamala, the motion has drawn attention to the lack of a clear operational guideline for the management of the funds gathered through the policy. The ad hoc committee is to meet with the Central Bank of Nigeria and other relevant agencies for a briefing on how the proceeds will be utilized. When the News at 10 returns, on our community report tonight, more trouble for internally displaced persons as they flee attacks on border communities in the Northeast. Join us again.
Our customers are focused.